beautiful butterfly. Something very clever. Very lucky, I come from a show business family. My dad worked in the circus, my auntie Caroline performed inside jokes and burlesque. She was what we called an exotic performer. And I've had routines handed down through the family, and I'm going to perform some of those routines for you tonight! Although some of the things that Auntie Caroline did, I'm not going near. Not going for it. Now, my dad, he started off working in the health service, but that didn't work out, and he joined Chipperfield Circus. Have you heard of Chipperfield Circus?
No!
My dad was part of the human cannonball crew. They built the cannon and the net the other end, and then at the end of the show they'd take it down, drive it off to the next venue. And my dad was understudy for Popovich, who was the cannonball. And for me, when I was a little lad, when I was about six, about that high, when he used to come down into the kitchen in his cannonball costume, the helmet and the leathers sparkle and the stripes, to me as a six-year-old, he was a superhero. Aww. It wasn't until I was a bit older that I realised what a twat he knew. But indeed, he did go on to be a bit of a record holder at it though. I don't know if you know, but the world record, the longest flight of a human cannonball, 180 feet. And that was by David Cannonball Smith in the United States. A very long way. And the world record for the shortest flight of a human cannonball, 1 foot 8 inches. And that was by Harry True to Drive It in the Kitchen organ. And the only training he got was an advice from the ringmaster who said, keep your knees bent, wear earplugs, and try not to crap yourself. Apparently that was the hard bit. And in the end, Chipperfields didn't take him on. They said he might make the grade, but it would be a long shot. Actually what they really said was it would be good if it was a long shot, but they were looking for somebody of a higher caliber. And can you believe, after all that, they fired him? Stop it now. I'm telling you about the Auntie Caroline. And Auntie Caroline were infamous for doing something called the Taiwanese ping pong ball routine. Anybody heard of that routine?
Yes.
Anybody tried that routine? Because I have to say, when I'm not built for it, but I have to say, if I were a woman, I'd have to try. Apparently very good for the pelvic floor muscles. And I think I've planted a little seed there for some of you. Been going home and going in the back of the cupboard and dusting off those ping pong balls. Now, I'm not going to do that routine, as I say, I'm not going for it. That's why I'm going to ask the lady here. I'm joking, I just to see your face, though, it was worth it. No, I am going to do a routine inspired by the Auntie Caroline. And she was so good at it, so good at what she did, she was asked by the National Lottery. Could she use a special talent to pick those big money balls? Because she could fit a 99 in, you know. Ladies can fit a lot in when you want to. In the end though, she had to give it up. After her second baby, she was losing a lot of pressure. The accuracy was growing. She did consider upgrading to tennis balls. But it wasn't until the football season started that she knew. Time to, I've gone too far now, I'm sorry. Ask you to do this evening, ladies and gentlemen, is keep your eye on the ping pong ball. Where is it, your mother? It's hard to focus, isn't it?
Oh, so we can get this. Oof. One through there. Ooh, that's just a sugar. You've got to tell me this. Now, I have in my pocket.
Why are you so? near the poles of peril. These are the poles that we're going to spin, well, say we. I'm going to spin some plates on. It is time to bring on Trevor's trolley. Who's this? It's Gary Giraffe! Everybody say hello, Gary!
Hello, Gary!
Now, Gary Giraffe he's got no friends and he's a little bit sad. But the next day, he went to the park and he met some children who played with him and became his friends, and that made him very happy! He ate something that didn't agree with him and he felt poorly. And then he died. Bit of a sad one. Now, ladies and gentlemen, these are the plates I'm going to spin for you this evening. And I've got some specials here. Look at this. This is an old one, the willow pattern. That's the willow. Your granny's got these. Willow pattern. It's got a date on it, this one. 1857. Microwave and dishwasher saver. It's ahead of its time. Now, I'm not going to be sending these plates up on those poles of peril without a warm up. You will see me warm them up with something called a Zen Flip. And I'll show you one of those now, a Zen Flip. Whoa. And occasionally, I'll do a tantric whirl. And then when they're warmed up, I'll be sending them up there. But I've got a couple more to show you. Look at this. Oh, who's that, you ask? That's my dog, Minton. And he's a very, very good dog, is Minton. Except sometimes he does eat all my shuttlecocks. I'm having a game. And the next time I want to play, there's me racket, but me shuttlecock chewed to bits. And I say, Minton, come here. And he comes up and he looks at the shuttlecock and he looks at me. And I say, bang, Minton. And then I pick the racket up and I'm twatting one with it. I don't, but it does make me gross when it does it. I've got one more to show you. One more, look at this. Oh, this is a special. Can you read that, sir? What does it say? Blackpool! Anybody been to Blackpool?
Yes!
If you've never been to Blackpool, the best time to go is 1957. All the papers fresh there. My mum, she loves Blackpool. She compares Blackpool to Paris. She says, compared to Paris, Blackpool's but it's got more fish and chip shops. And when someone insults you in Blackpool, you know what they're saying. Now it's time for the Super 7, ladies and gentlemen. Super 7, 7 spinning plates. It's going to be a wonder for you. This is my finale piece. I hope you're going to enjoy it. Are you ready for some plate spinning? Music, please! Let's get this first one up there. Churchill, China! Churchill, come on, warm it up. Here we go. Look at that! Shall we just leave it there?
No!
All right.
Keep going.
Yeah. Music plays. Come on.
Trevor.
Oh, look at this. The special.
Ladies and gentlemen, Trevor Organ! short 15-minute break, and then we're back for the final part of the show.